The 17th Lok Sabha commenced this week and we heard newly elected MPs shouting at the top of their lungs, chanting Vande Mataram, Bharat Mata Ki Jai, Jai Ma Kali, all hailing the mother. But do they really care about the mothers who are losing their children every single day in this country? Do they care about the misery of the parents who are losing their innocent children due to medical negligence and lack of infrastructure? Has the government failed to ensure even the basic healthcare facilities and infrastructure? Is the government's response clearly apathetic? Is the government not spending enough on healthcare in India? It certainly seems so, and that is the focus of the discussion today with me, Priyata Brajbasi. Let's take you through the developments of the day. 120 children have lost their lives due to encephalitis in Bihar in less than 2 weeks, and the numbers continue to rise. Now, another case of medical negligence has surfaced from UP's Bareilly, where a four-day-old lost her life as her parents had to run from pillar to post as doctors refused to admit her. The four-day-old baby Urvashi died as her parents ran from one building to another in Bareilly's Maharana Pratap Joint Hospital trying to get their daughter admitted. We are going to play a video for you, and in this video you can see the doctors in fact saying that there is no equipment. Now, Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has acted against the doctors. One doctor has been suspended and an investigation has been launched against the other doctor. But are the doctors only to be blamed in this scenario? The reality on the ground is that our government hospitals and doctors are working with very limited and inadequate resources. Here are some of the instances of medical negligence reported from across India. On June 9th this year, reports emerged of patients being treated on the floor of a hospital due to lack of beds in Rampur in Uttar Pradesh. On May 28th this year, a pregnant woman lost her child after waiting for more than 4 hours to go into labor in KGF Government Hospital in Kolar. On May 9th, a power cut led to deaths of 3 patients in Madurai. In March 2019, one child died and 16 fell critically ill after they were administered botched vaccinations. Such instances are plenty, and each of them speak of an extremely inadequate and inefficient healthcare infrastructure all across the country. Let's listen into some bites, in fact, from Bareilly in Uttar Pradesh today.
जब सही ही तो छुट्टी उन्हें तुरंत कर दी हॉस्पिटल में जब कमजोर थो दूध ना पी पाती तो हमने कही सबने जैसे किए कि इसे भर्ती कर दो तो जो इसके दम पर जाएगी तो जो सही हो जाएगी जब यहाँ भर्ती करने के लिए लाया करीब ना तीन साढ़े तीन घंटा हो गया यहाँ और वहाँ डॉक्टर के पास पर्चा ले गया तो कहीं वहाँ महिला वार्ड में ले जाओ वहाँ ले गए वहाँ से कही कि जिसने पर्चा बनाया वो ही भर्ती करेगा और फिर बाद में जब दोबारा ले गया तो बोले यहाँ बेड खाली नहीं है यहाँ ले जाओ इसके लिए तो इनके पास फिर आए तो फिर उस उनके पास हम गए तो उन्हें भर्ती नहीं करा बोले इसे रोल खंड ले जाओ फिर क्या जब हम नीचे आ रहे उतर के घर पे जाने के लिए तो नीचे हॉस्पिटल में ही ख़त्म होगी नीचे
उसमें कार्रवाई हुई है सीमेंस के खिलाफ कार्रवाई की गई है और इस प्रकार की लापरवाही सरकार स्वीकार नहीं करेगी
And let's open this discussion with our guests. We are being joined by Mamta Kale, who is a BJP leader. She's joining us from the national capital. We are also being joined by Dr. Sameer Dalwai, who is from the Indian Academy of Pediatrics, and he's joining us from Mumbai. I thank both of our guests for joining us. In fact, we're also going to be joined by Neelam Gupta, who is a child rights activist. She's going to join us in a short while from now. Now, let me start with Dr. Sameer Dalwai. The kind of situation that we are seeing emerging from our country right now in terms of our healthcare system, we have 120 children who have lost their lives due to encephalitis. We have about 100 who have lost their lives due to heat stroke. We've seen doctors in our country protesting over their security. Do you see this entire scenario as a failure, as a collapse of the state-run healthcare system in our country?
Yeah, of course, I see it as a failure of the state and government, but I also see it as a very clever, well-designed, sinister plan for the government of the day, whichever party they may be, to shift their entire responsibility for terrible work of their own towards the noble medical profession. And I'll tell you why. For the last 4 days, on behalf of the Indian Academy of Pediatrics, we were trying to coordinate with the officials in Bihar to offer our help as medical experts to help them combat the disease. And 2 days ago, the entire country has seen the pathetic state of affairs in Sri Krishna Medical Hospital in Muzaffarpur. You tell me, what is the point debating medically whether it's viral encephalitis or bacterial meningoencephalitis, right, when the ward in such a filthy condition that a normal healthy adult, if still left there, is going to contract a bad disease and die? What is the question of thinking about medical issues? This is straight and clear government failure.
Absolutely.
And abject apathy. The point we are trying to say is, in all these places, it's the government which hires doctors, it's the government which builds the infrastructure, it's the government which buys medicines. The doctor is an employee.
Right.
Now, if instead of operating on the right hand, the doctor operates on the left hand, that is what you may call medical negligence. But if there are no medicines, how can you call it medical negligence? And this is exactly what governments have done. They have put the doctor, who is an innocent guy, in front of the mob, when they should be the people who should be, the public should be venting their ire on. And very smartly, the government has sidestepped their responsibility. Where does all the health budget go? Why are there no medicines in the hospital?
So are you saying that why are there less doctors?
Who's
of course, it is a
money?
Failure of the government in terms of providing a medical an adequate infrastructure. But don't you think that at some level it is some amount of blame also needs to come on the doctors? Because, of course, let's talk about this case from Bareilly today. The parents of this 4-day-old child had to move from pillar to post to get their daughter admitted. But this hospital just refused to get this child admitted. If this is not medical negligence, what is?
Oh, let me give you an example. Suppose you want to go and start a company. If you want to take permissions, how many windows do you have to go to? If you have to take some permission, how many places you have to go to? Is the Babu sitting there responsible? It's the administration. So the doctor sitting there is not responsible for telling the patient to go from pillar to post. It's the administration. Why hasn't the administration made the admission facility stamped forward? The doctor's negligence comes in when he refuses to see a patient. When he has 8 hours of work, and in that 8 hours he doesn't do. Our doctors work for 48 hours.
All right.
In spite of that, they are trying to use their medical knowledge to bring relief to the patient. So
all right,
wrong.
Let me go across to Mamta Kale now. Mamta, of course, you're not a representative of the government. However, you are a representative of the party that has formed the government in the past 5 years and, in fact, has been re-elected once again. How are you looking at the apathetic response that we are seeing from ministers, leaders, from all across the country? Of course, we had Dr. Harshvardhan, who went to Bihar a few days ago. He did address the media, but all he's been telling the media is that everything that can be done is being done. You have Nitish Kumar, who goes to Muzaffarpur after 100 children have already died. You have one minister who is asking for cricket scores during a medical briefing, another who is napping, and another who calls encephalitis a natural disaster. He calls it a natural calamity. So how are you looking at the apathetic response of our ministers in this whole scenario?
Firstly, I would like to say that it is very disheartening to see the sad demise of our sad and untimely demise of our 120 children. I pray to God that this does not happen to any part of our country. whatever, maybe it any virus infection or anything. You know, we have seen this in the past in Kerala as well, that we almost 700 people got infected due to Nipah virus, and almost 50 to 75% people died due to it. So these virus diseases keep spreading and happening in various part of our country. And the results have not yet out, and people have not been able to understand as to, you know, what does which is this exact virus and how does it spread. So this is the similar case which happened in Muzaffarpur, which was absolutely shocking and sad to see. And I would like to say that no government wants their people to die like this. You know, they are also concerned about the health care of the
but
people.
But Mamta, this is not the first time that encephalitis is happening in Bihar. It happens year after year. It has been happening for a decade. It happens year after year. However, this time we've seen the largest number of child deaths in the
Agreed.
Past 5 years. Is our government not prepared? Is that what you're saying?
Agreed that this No, agreed. This particular virus has been a cause of concern and killing people for years together. And this has to be understood and dealt with as to why is this happening and what is this virus and how does it spread. So this has to be understood by doctors and the medical facilities of Bihar. Particularly, the Chief Minister Nitish Kumarji had visited Muzaffarpur a few days back. It was late, I agree with you, but he promised and he promised 2,500 beds to be included in the in this particular hospital, which presently has just 610 beds. Having said that, there is a problem in Bihar again, where we have very few doctors registered to work there. You know, if we see in India, we
all
have
right.
10 lakh doctors registered all across, and only in Bihar we have 40,000 doctors. So it becomes a problem as for the government, any government for that matter.
Right.
To
in fact,
employ
let me get
the
in Neelam Gupta, who's a child rights activist. She's also joining us on this broadcast. Let me get her into the conversation. Neelam, why do you think that every time something like this happens, why do you think that our government's response is never preemptive, it is always responsive? Why are we always responding to a situation as opposed to preparing for it well in advance?
It is absolutely shameful the way we behave. A problem which is occurring year on year. Since 2008, we have figures to show that 44,000 cases have been reported of this type of disease. And all over India, we have innumerable cases of different kinds of diseases and different child deaths due to various diseases. But no action is being taken. We totally lack in any kind of peripheral health care. You know, in villages, we have public health centers which are only catering to 13% of population, that too not equipped at all. We are totally zero in peripheral health care. We are very poor in secondary and tertiary health care also, because there is huge load on those hospitals which are ill-equipped to handle any kind of cases. Then I would ask Mamta ji, she's just saying that, you know, a disease has to be identified and virus has to be identified and cure has to be identified. But why can't we give preventive health facilities to
right.
our villages, you know, to our children? There is lack of nutrition, they are weak. Why do they fall prey to diseases at all? That is my question. Why can't we have preventive health? If we have lack of doctors, if we don't have enough doctors, we can have paramedical forces. We can have paramedical teams which can be sent to areas to make people aware of such things.
Right. In fact, I have some numbers with me on this program today.
So
I have some numbers with me. Let's talk about the percentage of the GDP that countries spend on their healthcare. We have India that spends 1.5% of their GDP on healthcare. We have United States that spends 17.2% of their GDP on healthcare. United Kingdom spends 9.76%. France spends 11.5 and Germany spends 11.3. India spends 1.5. And that is exactly why this sort of a situation has now emerged from across our country. How will you respond to that, Dr. Sameer?
Yeah, I'd just like to rebut Ms. Mamta Kale there. She's talked about virus not being isolated. I want to give this message very clearly as a responsible doctor. This is not some unknown scary virus that you are fighting. No, sorry, please get your facts right. Have you isolated a single virus in the last few years on this condition? No, it is not a virus. It is the malnutrition, it is the dehydration that is killing these children. Please be corrected. And the second point I wanted to make you understand is you talked about the virus. Just in case there is a virus, have you gone and seen the condition of the hospital?
My facts are pretty clear, doctor. It is due to malnutrition, I know.
If you see the
virus, then it is due to the virus as well.
All right, doctor. Sameer, just respond to my
correcting your facts.
Do not interrupt me.
All right.
Do not interrupt me. Let me finish.
I am correcting your facts too.
All right, Mamta, I'll let you respond. I will let you respond to Dr. Sameer. I'll let you respond to him. Let him finish. Let him finish. I'll let you respond to him.
Please, doctor.
Do not interrupt me. You will not interrupt me. Let me complete.
Right. Just go on, Dr. Sameer.
I did not interrupt you. Be quiet. Let me complete.
I am just correcting your facts.
So the second point is, please go to this ward in Muzaffarpur and spend 2 days there and see how healthy you feel. Please go and see. And who is responsible for that ward? Who is responsible for the gutter flowing through the wards? Who is responsible for the filth in the ward? Is that the doctor's responsibility? So there is, forget the virus. Don't blame it on some medical science. This is not some aliens who are attacking us. This is the dirt in the hospitals which you have ignored over the last so many years. It is your mistake. And the government better accept that mistake. Don't hide behind viruses.
Right.
There are no viruses.
Let me get Neelam Gupta into the conversation. Neelam, do you think that as a country we need to now start spending more on healthcare? We haven't spent enough. I just gave you all of these numbers. We are spending very, very little of our GDP on healthcare. And now I think it's about time that we need to start investing more and more on our state healthcare facilities.
Absolutely. Health is the basic requirement. You know, without health, where are we? We plan of going to moon. We are planning bullet trains. We are planning to be superpower. But without health of our children, without health of the future wealth that we have, our children, where are we going to stand in the world? Where are we going to stand globally? You know, it's the basic requirement of the country. And we are totally failing. Our government is failing. We are just not doing enough. We have built some buildings in the name of public health centers in the villages, but they are not functioning, they are not equipped, they don't have basic infrastructure. We are not addressing preventive health systems, which people are not aware of. How will they prevent their diseases? It's shameful, the country, that we are now 70 years of independence and we are standing like this looking at these horrible cases of neglect and negligence of the government. I don't blame doctors, we don't blame anybody but the government governance and the government systems. The lack of political will. Why can't a Pradhan, why can't an MLA be made responsible for their areas? Why can't they look into the facilities which are in their areas? Why can't they look at the programs which are running in their areas for preventive health care and promotive health care? This can be easily avoided. There is nothing, no big deal in this.
Absolutely,
there is no,
and in fact, you're right about the fact that accountability in this entire scenario, at least when it comes to encephalitis in Bihar, the outbreak of encephalitis in Bihar, and 120
zero.
Children having lost their lives, there's no accountability that has been set. No heads have rolled in the government,
in the
health department of the state. In fact, no accountability has been set. Dr. Sameer, how will you respond to that?
That's a shame. That's a shame, and that shows how shameless the political class has become. And somebody is trying to put the blame on doctors. How dare anybody defend this? And it's my challenge. Let every MLA, MP, and elected representative from Muzaffarpur be inside that hospital for 3 days. Let them spend 3 days inside that hospital and show us whether they're healthy at the end of it or no.
Let's not make it about that. Let's talk about the reality on the ground right now. How do you look at this entire scenario? Do you think that the government needs to set accountability?
Absolutely. The government needs to set responsibility. Who was the person in charge of the hospital? The person in charge of the hospital needs to answer why there is a filth and a gutter inside the hospital. He needs to answer that.
Right, and Mamta, this whole scenario about the government not having done enough, the government, in fact, we were talking about the apathetic response of the government, the state government in Bihar, and in fact even the central government. How do you defend the government in this scenario?
See, it is not about defending the government. Government should take corrective measures and do whatever is required to keep the hospitals and the environment and then surrounding clean. And it should be well equipped. Having said that, I also want to say the sad, one more sad part and sad truth. You know, our generation, our people who do take the degree of MBBS, MD from government colleges, and thereafter, they don't wish to work to remote areas. You know, given a chance, they want to come and work and set up their own practices or work in A-tier cities. Very few of them would want to go to remote areas, villages, and serve the people there. The doctors, you know, will come, scream, shout, make tall claims. But if you ask them to go and work to these remote areas, villages, they would refuse. They would not go. So I want to request an appeal to the doctors that they should go and at least work for 10 years in remote areas and villages so that it becomes easy for any government, I quote, you know, to give medical facilities easily to the remote areas and to villagers. And villagers also can have that faith that they have so-called Bhagwan. Hum doctors ko Bhagwan bulate hain, that Bhagwan around us. And these doctors should not only come to A-tier cities to work, should go and work in villages.
But Mamta, you can't deny the fact that the government doctors in these state, in the rural areas of the state, in fact, are working with very limited resources. They're working with, they don't even have basic infrastructure. So the doctors are, in fact, even working with the least amount of resources imaginable.
Absolutely right.
Yeah. Yes. So in my opening sentence, this is what I said, that government should provide with the equipment, medicine, correct infrastructure and cleanliness. It should be given to every state, village by the government. That was my first point. And my second point was this, pertaining the doctors not accepting and going to villages, to remote areas to work. This is also a reality, you know, and we have to bring it. We have to speak to these doctors and the doctor fraternity as to why don't they go. To serve
Dr. Sameer, how will you respond to what Mamta is saying?
They should be selfless and go there.
It's very easy to respond to Mrs. Kale's suggestions. One, you are in government, make a law that doctors who pass out will be forced to work in the rural areas for 5 years.
Absolutely.
What's stopping you from doing that? Please go ahead and enact that law. The second thing is, if I'm a surgeon, I cannot operate with my bare hands. I need an operation theater which is sterile, which has all the equipment, which has all the instruments, and which has a trained nurse. Okay, first provide that. If you can't provide that, I can't go there and do some mumbo jumbo. Please first provide the infrastructure, increase the medical college seats, increase the training, and yes, if you want doctors to work in these areas, increase their salary. See to it that they have good living conditions in addition to the medical infrastructure.
I just want to take a quick, I want to take last responses from all of our panelists. India has one of the low, in fact, they have the worst mortality. India has the worst mortality, infant mortality rate in the world. What are the immediate steps that the government needs to take in order to fix this scenario? Let me start with Neelam.
Yeah, I think the government should focus on the peripheral health care immediately and with an urgency, because there is total lack of peripheral health care. We are only doing lip service, we are just making statements, but in reality, in most of the villages, there is no health care. The ANMs who have been appointed are not trained enough, they do not know their job, they are not attending to their jobs. So absolutely, there is lack of medical facilities and healthcare facilities at the rural areas. So we need to really focus our attention immediately there, where 70% of our population lives, and
right.
There is
Dr.
hardly
Sameer,
10%
seconds,
of facilities
your last,
available.
Your
in
last
those areas,
response, your
which
last
is a
thought.
Very big gap.
We need nothing less than a revolution, and that revolution is make a public audit of each and every health facility that we have in this country. And whoever is responsible, hold a public trial for that person in public and give him punishment. That's the only way you can improve the health system.
All right, Mamta, your last thoughts.
I wish, hope and pray that this does not get repeated in any part of our country. I would, my appeal to all the doctors and the Bihar government also to look into this and fix it, address it as soon as possible. And my condolences to the families of these kids.
Right, I want to thank all of our guests for joining us on this broadcast. Mamta Kale, Dr. Sameer Dalwai and Neelam Gupta for joining us on this program. I would like to thank all of them. Of course, this is an ongoing situation. This is something that the government does have to deal with immediately. Children are dying in Bihar. Specifically, 120 children have died due to encephalitis. And we are hearing time and again, we are hearing cases of medical negligence that is resulting in deaths of more children. The government has to come up with a plan to curb this situation as soon as possible. News and updates will continue on Tiranga TV. That's all that we have. Thanks for watching.